Light is the type of energy that allows you to see. Light allows us to see everything from the goodies in our lunchbox through to the stars at night.
Light waves shine out from a light source, bounce off different objects, and then go into your eyes. Light travels so fast that it can circle Earth 7 times in 1 second. Light comes from the sun, electric lights, or from hot burning things such as candles and fire. Our biggest light and energy source is the sun. Without light, you would not have food to eat or air to breathe. That's because plants and many kinds of ocean life use light from the sun to make food and oxygen. Here is Zach. All the food that he eats and the oxygen he breathes can be traced to these things and therefore to light. Light travels in a straight path until it hits an object, then several things can happen.
Light can be absorbed as by this shade cloth or reflected as it is by this water.
Objects that are opaque absorb and reflect light. Opaque objects do not allow light to pass through them. Objects that are translucent will allow some light to pass through them, and objects that are transparent will let nearly all the light pass through. Here is Zach again. He is opaque. He is looking through a transparent window and he's almost hidden by a translucent blind. Oh, wow, it looks as though Zach is a part of a shadow puppet show. Hang on, is that dinosaur going to eat Zach? Oh, no. Let's move on to refraction. When light passes between air and water, it bends or refracts as it moves more slowly through water than air. Have you ever noticed that a straw bends in a glass of water? That's refraction. How can refraction help us see? Glass telescopes, microscopes, and cameras all contain lenses, specially cut pieces of plastic or glass that curves inwards concave or outwards convex. The light that we see is white light. It is really a mixture of colors, each with a different wavelength. If white light passes through a triangular piece of glass or plastic called a prism, the prism bends the white light, breaking it up into separate colors. These are called the colors of the spectrum. A rainbow is really a spectrum in the sky. Rainbows are formed when the sun shines while it is raining. Each raindrop acts as a tiny prism, splitting up the sunlight into the various colors: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. This process is called refraction. You can also see it when you blow bubbles. So if light can bend, why can't you see Zach around this corner? Light waves travel in a straight line. They cannot turn corners or bend of their own accord. They have to hit something first. When light rays hit a shiny surface like a mirror, they bounce off or are reflected. The moon shines because it reflects sunlight. Ari and Zach are opaque objects. Here they are casting shadows because light can't pass through them. Instead, they absorb or reflect light, leaving a black area behind them. Seeing colors. Objects absorb different amounts and colors of light. Here is Ari in his karate gi. White objects are often bright because they don't absorb any light. Instead, it reflects it back into your eyes. Black objects absorb all colors. Nothing reflects, which is why they look black, like Jason on his motorbike. Other objects absorb all the colors except for the colors they appear to be. For example, green leaves absorb most colors but reflect green light back. That is why green leaves look green. Although there are 7 colors of light in the light spectrum, 3 colors are known as the primary colors of light. They are red, blue, and green. When you use paint, the primary colors of paint are different. They're red, blue, and yellow. When they're mixed together, they make a murky brown color. But if you shine the primary colors of light together, red, blue, and green, they will make white light. Reflecting light. All surfaces reflect some light. If they didn't, we wouldn't be able to see them. But some surfaces are better at reflecting than others. Smooth, shiny, light-colored things reflect more light than dull, uneven, dark things. That is why you can see your face reflected in a flat, shiny mirror and not in a dark, bumpy tree. If you shine a torch straight at a mirror, it will bounce straight back at you. If you shine the torch at an angle, the light will bounce off the mirror at an equal and opposite angle on the other side than normal. This is the rule of reflection. The angle of incidence equals the angle of reflection. The rule of reflection only works for flat, smooth mirror known as a plane mirror. Uneven surfaces reflect light in all different directions. Physicists call this scattering. Total internal reflection is when light is trapped inside a substance because it reflects repeatedly. In TIR, no light is absorbed as the light travels. This is very useful and is used in fiber optic cables, which help perform medical operations and carry light signals for telephones, the internet, and television. So, thank you, light.
Though I've loved you.